At the beginning of your education in the fundamentals of anatomy and physiology, the first place you always start is with the concept of homeostasis. And I want to begin the conversation about homeostasis by talking about the concept of feedback and by asking a very important question. And that question is, how does the human body react to a constantly changing environment? We know the environment around our bodies is always changing, and I think it's also basically understood by common sense that when the environment around our body changes, the environment within our body changes. And in spite of that interchange, we maintain a certain amount of stability within our bodies. And so the question is, how can we react to a changing environment and maintain any kind of stability? And the answer is with what's called feedback. With feedback, a system reacts to a change by producing a change. Or to put this in the context of the human body, when a physiological variable changes, the response is to further change that same variable. And that's what feedback is. And there are two types of feedback. There's positive and there's negative. Now, up front, you need to understand these two words, positive and negative, are not good and bad. These are mathematical terms. And so positive feedback means responding to any change in the variable by amplifying or adding to that change. Whatever the change is, we do more of it. So as an example, here's a generic physiological variable. The line represents the set point or average value. And the environment changes in such a way that the variable increases. Positive feedback in response to this increase would be additional increase. By contrast, if the initial change had been to decrease the variable's value, positive feedback would have further decreased it. So notice, positive feedback doesn't make the value go up. It just takes whatever the change is and does more of it. The opposite of positive feedback is negative feedback, which doesn't add to the change. It subtracts from it or reverses the initial change. Whatever we start with, negative feedback does the opposite. And so again, if we have our generic variable at set point and the environment changes in a way that causes the value to go up, negative feedback would cause the value to come back down. On the other hand, if the initial change was a decrease, negative feedback would make the value come back up. So again, notice positive feedback isn't good, negative feedback isn't bad. Positive feedback doesn't increase, negative feedback doesn't necessarily decrease. Positive feedback takes whatever the change was initially and adds to it. Negative feedback takes whatever the change was initially and reverses it. And with that as our starting point, we're ready to now talk about what is homeostasis.